Welcome. I'll take you through the process of creating a vector portrait like this. First, we need a good photo. Make two copies of this photo. Activate the first one. Window, image trace, make sure the preview is not checked. Change the mode to color, palette, full tone, 20, 20, 20, and 20. Press preview, then go to object, image trace, expand. This will turn the image into passes. Lock this, label this low res, hides it. Select the next image, change the mode to color, palette, full tone, 50, 50, 50, and 50. Press preview. This is the higher resolution separation. Object, image trace, expand. Locks this, label this high res, and close this. So we have now a low resolution separation. This will be good for skin tone. We also have a high resolution separation. This will be good for areas that require more details. And we also have the original image, good for details around the eyes, nose, and mouth. Three of the most important areas. For a vector portrait, we need to start with eyes first. Then we need to capture the nose tip and the mouth. All three areas require looking at the original photo. We'll start with the eyes. The first pass we will capture is the outside shape of the eye. The next pass we want to draw below this pass. So it's very important to come over here, choose from draw normal to draw behind. This pass was created using the pen tool. Press P for the pen tool, click and drag. Then the next point is down here. You need a sharp point, so click only once. Back to here again, click and drag. Come down to the next area, click and drag. Back to here, click and drag. In case you don't like to see the fill, switch the fill to stroke. Back to the original point, when you see an O, that means you will close the pass. So click and drag. Press A to fine-tune this. When you're ready, you can press the eyedropper and pick the color from the photo. Using the pen tool delivers the highest quality pass. A less precise way to create something similar is using the pencil tool. Press N to go to the pencil tool, double click, set the smooth to the highest setting, keep selected, close pass, edit select the pass. Draw the pass, come back when you see an O, release. To make modification, go over the pass again. And you can see it creates many anchor points and is much less precise. Also, it is harder to get this absolutely perfect. To eliminate so many anchor points, you can go to Object, Pass, Simplify to create the smoothness you need. You can see the process actually takes longer than using the pen tool. The next pass for the eye is this one. And you can see how many anchor points are needed. Press P, start, switch this to stroke, click and drag, press Options or Alt to break the handle. Click and drag, come back to the original point, click and drag. Press A to fine-tune the path. This method is clearly superior than the pencil tool. When you're satisfied with the shape, switch the stroke to fill. To do this with the pencil tool, eyedropper, pick the color. The next pass, then go into the highlight, highlight, another highlight, pupil, iris with a stroke, the white of the eye. Don't choose something too bright right away, gradually moving backward. After the eye is finished, move on to eyelashes. Use the pen tool or the brush tool to put in the lashes one at a time. Using the pen tool, click and drag, press escape, choose stroke. Click on this, press V to activate it. You should see these options show up. Change the profile from uniform to this. The thick end is on top. I want to switch it, come to the stroke. Right here when you see the profile, there's a button to switch the orientation. Another way to do it is while you're in the pen tool, when you see a slash, click and that will switch the orientation as well. Press escape. Another way to generate eyelashes will be using the brush tool. Press B to go to the brush tool. Double click. I normally set the smooth to the second setting. Edit, select the pass. I had created 5 different custom brushes using these profiles. The brush created with the smallest profile is perfect for hair or eyelashes. That's the thinnest one. And you can see it's very quick and easy. This is good for the smaller eyelashes on the bottom as well. This is how you can create an eye. For the left eye, use identical method. Next, we'll move on to the tip of the nose. First pass and the second pass, both using the pen tool. Next, the eyebrows. Create a clipping pass for both sides. Then use the high resolution separation to create one pass, second, third, fourth, and fifth. For the mouth, first create a clipping pass to cover the entire upper lip. Then compare high and low separation. The high separation seems to work better. So create another pass and another, complete the upper lip. For the lower lip, create a clipping pass and use the low resolution separation since it worked better. Create a highlight, second pass, third, and complete. For the teeth, we'll put in the highlight first, then the gaps of the teeth. Block in the teeth one section at a time. All of the most important facial features are now completed. Next, we'll work on the skin tones. For the skin tone, we'll use mostly the low resolution separation. We'll go from rough separation to something smooth like this. Going backward, so first pass, second, third, fourth, and fifth. Blend your passes as smoothly as possible. On the opposite side, first pass, second, third, fourth. For area between the eyebrows, I created a clipping path, then the first path, and then the second. Next, we'll move on to the nose. We'll go from rough separation to something smooth like this. A clipping path was created. Create a first pass, second. Moving on to the next area, rough image trace, smooth artwork. Next. Blend your passes as smoothly as possible. For the rest of the face, image trace the smooth artwork we need. Starting with the chin area, moving backward. For the forehead, I'm not too satisfied with the image trace separation, so I created my own pattern. Starting with the center, moving to the left, all the way into the hairline area. The face is done. The next step is to work on the hair. For the hair and the eyebrows, I'll choose a medium-sized brush. Using the brush tool, switching to the smaller one, then select all the passes, object, pass, outline stroke. Turn them into outlines, then use the pathfinder, merge them all together, object, path, simplify, to smooth out the path. Press I for the eyedropper. For the hair region, use a thicker brush tip. Same method, choose the brush stroke, object, path, outline stroke, merge them together, object, path, simplify. Or you can use the pencil tool. Eyedropper. So these are some of the techniques you can use to handle the hair area. Using the low resolution separation, I created the hair area. Basically, just smooth out all of the textures. Moving on to the clothing, I use a clipping mask to contain all of the elements. Then the neck, I pretty much follow the image trace fairly closely. Left side of the hair, the clothing on the back side, the jewelry. Finally, adding a blue background and the image is finished. I use the pen tool for all of the skin areas. And I use pencil tools for most of the hair area. So this is how you create a vector portrait.